We have two undefeated clubs in here, number one against number two, conference against conference. And we've got two teams here who have been just dying to get at one another. And this is going to be it. It caps the week. It is going to be perhaps, well, it's a marquee game for everybody in the boys' classification. I think East or West, because this has been the game that everybody has been wanting to see.
Well, let me tell you a story. Outside in the parking lot, I was out there just a moment ago, and someone came up and said, "Hey, are you from Winthrop?" And I said, "No, I'm with public television." She said, "Good, because this would be your last game." I mean, the emotion is running high, even among the fans.
Well, hey, look, the fans have been getting here. They were going to come anyway, but we happen to think, from what we've seen thus far, that this whole tournament has pivoted on one play. We were looking at the semifinal game between Jay and Winthrop, and Jay came in here looking to avenge their losses on the season to the Winthrop Ramblers. We had a strong C boys bracket, and coming into that game, even after come up with an answer. Now
we're here with Warren Cassette, undefeated and second ranked the Wiscasset Indians here. Warren, everybody healthy going into this game?
Actually, we're missing a boy, Jeremy Rankin, tonight because he has a fractured kneecap. That was a reoccurring injury that we didn't know anything about. The trainers up here said it was a patella tendon, and it ended up being a fractured kneecap after further investigation. So we're missing him.
Who will replace him in your starting lineup?
Justin Tancredi will replace him.
A lot of people think that you're into this as a David and Goliath situation. You're undefeated. You're playing a team that many people say is one of the better teams of all time. How do you approach this game?
I approach this game as any other game. They're a team, we're a team. They have some good players. We have a lot of exceptional players, and we're going to work hard and hopefully work harder than the other team.
Warren, you've announced that defense will be the key to this ball game. Do you still believe that?
I do believe that. I believe their defense is very good and our defense is very good, and we can both put a lot of points on the board. Defense will be the key, and hopefully it'll be a war of attrition, I think, tonight.
Any tactical changes that you've made coming into this game?
Not really.
Turn the clock on. Let's go get him. Warren Cassette, best of luck to you.
Thank you very much.
John?
Thank you very much, John Coughlin. Of course, we'll be talking with Dave Poulin a little bit later on, but a similarity between the two teams, they love to run, both of them.
They love to run. They are loaded with athletes and kids who really take to the floor. And while you're out in the parking lot, I'm out in the runway here. And the Wiscasset people are saying, you watch. Corey Johnson tonight is going to put on a show because he wants to rise to the occasion. Of all of the kids on that Wiscasset club, he's the one who can make a presence for himself, similar to that, the TJ Caueta. Now, Corey Johnson is not the same height and doesn't have the same game. He's got a different game. Loves to run the floor, loves to bang the boards, has got a deadly accurate shot from within 10 feet of the hoop. I don't really think I've seen him take a shot from outside that, but he hasn't had to. He hasn't had to unveil that part of his game. If he wants to show some folks what he can do, he's one who could take this game over, too. And, I think Warren may have been kind of diving John a little bit. Yeah, Jeremy Rankin is going to be missed, but Corey Johnson may just have to step up and be a big, big player tonight for the Redskins.
John Coughlin is standing by with head coach Dave Poulin of the Winthrop Ramblers. John?
We're here with Dave Poulin, top-ranked, undefeated, about to go against another undefeated team. David, does that have any mental approach, any difference of mental approach as you play an undefeated team?
Not for us. We've played one game at a time all year long. I think the sad thing is that somebody's going to go home with a first loss and a runner-up rather than a champion. They're a great team, quality team. I'm hoping tonight, though, maybe our schedule, maybe our extra games and maybe those things, we stretched our ability against the Bangor, against the Barney Eagle, and things like that. I'm hoping that might make a difference.
Your kids obviously played very, very well in this tournament, and it seems that you're peaking at the right time. Kids are playing with a great deal of confidence at this point.
Very, very confident. We want our kids, every one of them, to attack the basket all night tonight, and we're hoping we're going to get them in some foul trouble. We'd love to do what we did the other night and play our bench against Dave. We can go 9 deep with some really talented kids.
Obviously, you have the backing of your town here. They're here in force. I don't believe there are many people left in Winthrop tonight, David.
It's awesome. It is just absolutely tremendous to coach basketball in Winthrop and to play basketball. And I know Ray feels the same way, that people just love the game.
As you approach this ball game, David, any tactical changes or adjustments that you're making coming into this one?
Yeah, we're going to run some straight man pressure, and we're going to run some man with a center fielder that I know you used to
it builds. The emotion now. High school basketball at its very finest, right here on the stations of Maine Public Television. Winthrop's on the court. Good captain to join them. DJ Cowan will jump it off with Corey Johnson. Well, sit back. Enjoy this one.
Dick Lorenz is saying you got to move your car bump.
No.
I ain't leaving.
So the boys see Western Maine marbles are underway. Robert Beal picks up O'Hearn on the guard. Now to Bliley outside. Torrey Carr at the top. Underneath to Johnson. His spot from the left side. Doesn't take it. Carr drives the lane. Dishes now to Tancredi. Fed to Johnson. Inside. Goes up and doesn't get it. Wave it off anyway, and they call the foul.
Jason Nuzzo on the reach-in. Already we're seeing both these clubs are going to be very active. And you already said that, Don. They love to go to the hole. Both coaches are telling them to go that way. But watch 32 in red. I think he's going to have a monster game.
The foul is called on T.J. Cowett.
Whoa.
They'd love to get him in foul trouble if they could. Whit Cassett would. This is Robert Beal outside. Torrey Carr, the drive, pop. Partially blocked. Cowett down with the rebound. Determination on his face. Here he comes. Lays it up and in. There was fire in the eye. 2-0 with Cassett. Winthrop breaks on top. Torrey Carr with the basketball outside. Guarded by Contreras. This is at the deal. The pop shot no good. Here's Johnson. He's open on the other side. Lays it up and in. We are tied at 2. Just under 7 minutes to go. First quarter. T.J. Cowett. Top shot blocked away from him and out of his hands. Here's Johnson picking it up. Got Tancredi. He lays it up and in.
Just as advertised.
West Cassett leads it 4-2. Underneath for Jeff Packard in the paint. Spin, shot, no good. Rebound, Contreras up and no good. Rebound inside, Nuzzo fouled. There is an intensity to this first quarter. You can just feel it.
These kids have been waiting around all day. A lot of us have been waiting around all year. The Mountain Valley Conference, the Mid-Maine Conference, the bragging rights all around for this one. And you know, the thing I like about it is this game is going to be played about a foot and a half higher than most of the games we've seen thus far in the tournament.
Nailed the personal foul on Torrey Carr, his first one, and the first team foul against Wiscasset. And here's Jason Nuzzo, senior center, and off the rim, no good. 4-3, Wiscasset comes down leading by one. Carr on the right side, throws up a 15-footer off the rim, no good. Rebound, battle for Packard, comes away with it. Down court quickly. Here's Cowett in the paint. Hop shot. Got it. 5-4. Winthrop is leading by one. Winthrop started slow in their semifinal game and then just blew it away on that dunk that we showed you just before the game started by T.J. Cowett. Here's Bliley. Fed underneath nicely. Beal with the shot. It's 6-5. With Cassett is leading by one.
Reach and foul in the backcourt on Torrey Carr.
That's two on him. We'll watch that. He's picked up two quick fouls.
They bring in Adam Newcomb. He's talking to Warren Cassette. Carr wants to stay in. Says, I'll behave.
Andy O'Hearn out on top to Packard. Three-pointer on the way. Off the back of the iron. No good. Rebound comes down to Newcomb, who just came into the basketball game. Bliley leaves it in the backcourt for Robert Beal. And Beal on the drive. To Bliley. Bliley over Packard for the shot. Off the rim. No good. Rebound battle for Cowett. Takes it away from Tancredi. Here's TJ again. 8-foot pop. Around the rim, no good. Rebound, Corey Johnson. And the whistle for the foul. They're going to call Contreras on the push.
He looked incredulous at that, Don. He got moved out of there as if he was some sort of lightweight. Watch this. Johnson, look at Contreras. Might have been the reaching on the arm, but wow, I really got hit.
They spun him right out. Full court pressure now by the Winthrop Ramblers. Down it comes Tancredi to Newcomb in the corner. Back out on top to Beal and Newcomb. Johnson, right side of the lane, lays it up and in. Now Ed backs off him a little bit. He doesn't want to pick up another personal foul this early. Here's O'Hearn out of control. Crashes in. No foul on the play. Simply out of bounds, and it will belong to Winthrop. It is 8-5, with Cassett is leading by three. As Cassett comes in here, ranked number two, and Winthrop number one, Packard the three-pointer around the rim and out. Had it three-quarters of the way down the cylinder, but it would not drop.
Corey Johnson's asserting himself both ends of the court.
Nuzzo is going to get called for a foul. You could hear it. 52 with the elbow.
Tried to force his way through.
Nuzzo's first personal foul. Team foul number three against Winthrop. Robert Beal with the basketball. Inside to Johnson. He's open again for the shot. Nuzzo gambles on the steal. Johnson gets three. It is 10-5 with Cassett.
6 points for Johnson.
Cowett looks inside. Now drives the lane. Taken away from him. Here's Newcomb. Johnson crashes into Contreras. Player control.
And Contreras, look at this.
Contreras is hurt.
Corey Johnson lowered the shoulder, and I think he might have hit Contreras. It looks like an ankle, maybe, but he is in pain.
Here's
Corey Johnson. He's set here. The knee.
He went down hard.
Knee-to-knee contact. I hope it's not a twist. I hope there's nothing serious. We have seen our share of that this week already.
Chris Cimitelli.
Right there.
Is out there.
And John Coughlin is making his way over. Warren Cassette.
Matt Harris has come in to replace him. This is Eric Lau. Had a wonderful semifinal game. Cowett saves it from the backcourt. Winthrop is trailing by five here in the first quarter. 3:46 to go. Here's Lau. Drive to the lane. Shovels it underneath. Looking for Nuzzo. But good defense by the Wisconsin Redskins forced the errant pass and out of bounds.
10-5, but the intensity isn't nickel and dime.
And if you just joined us, Winthrop has lost a weapon. Steve Contreras down with an ankle injury. Here's Johnson free again. He puts it up. It's good. And he got fouled by Nuzzo.
8 points for Corey Johnson. What a great entry pass. How fluent. Johnson had the head fake, got Nuzzo in the air for his second foul. Because as he went back up, the body contact was there. But that's the one thing Corey Johnson has shown over and over in this tournament. He is not afraid of the body contact. In fact, his game's almost better with it.
If contact is allowed by the officials, depending on how much contact they're going to allow, I would say the more contact would play to the favor of Wisconsin, because they're a smaller team, and if they can bang and slap a little bit. Stolen by Robert Beal. Beal now. Winthrop a bit discombobulated. Dropped out of bounds on the block.
Eric Lau trying to make amends for throwing the ball. He telegraphed the pass, so Beal was able to get it.
Wiley, inbound pass. Tancredi in the corner. Watched by Coed. Drives past him. Beats Johnson. He lays it up and in. Right now, they do not have an answer for Corey Johnson. Winthrop wants timeout.
11 points for Corey Johnson. 11 of the 15 for the Wisconsin Redskins. And he just loves anything that's on that red coat of the floor, left or right tonight.
Our score, short change to Wisconsin by 1 point. It is 15-5. And we'll get that corrected. A 10-point lead for the Wisconsin Redskins who come in here ranked number two. And, of course, we've said this many times. We'll say it one more time. If it's the 1-2 draw, there really is no favorite.
Not between two undefeated clubs who play in different conferences. And both, not only are they proud, but they carry themselves real well. You're not going to see them get rattled. They're going to stay on their game plan. Each team, Jeremy Rankin for Wiscasset, now Steve Contreras for Winthrop.
So before you turn it off, what we're saying is Winthrop started slow in every game that they played. It is at about this time that the Ramblers tend to make a run, and they need it. Wow. Underneath the Trenholm. Cowette bumps his way in. Yeah, and doesn't get it. Gets his own rebound, lays it up, and doesn't get that one. And Wiscasset down with it. Here's Corey Johnson. Tancredi.
Travels.
Ooh. Gets called for the walk.
T.J. Cowette overcompensated. He went up two spots on the first layup, got his own rebound, and then was so anxious to get it back, he put too much on the putback.
Two and a half minutes left to go. Eric Lau out to O'Hearn. O'Hearn bounced to Packard on the left side. Packard bottled up. Trenholm in the center. Will lay it up and in. Winthrop with full court pressure here now, trying to create mistakes. Wiley gets it across the 10-second line on the fingers of Beal. Now with it is Nate Falkingham, who's in the basketball game. Taken away from Tancredi by Cowett. And back come the Ramblers. Eric Lau, Packard, three-pointer on the way. No. Jeff Packard has missed three attempts at a three-pointer here. 15-7. Wiscasset comes down in the lead. Corey Carr, drive, stop. Five-footer is good. 17-7. Wiscasset by 10. Warren Crosette up. Stolen again. Falkingham cruises in, lays it up, and no good. Rebound pulled down by Cowette. And now both teams are starting to run. Here's Cowette. Loses control of the dribble.
Whoa. Interesting call there. I thought he might have tipped that out of bounds himself. TJ is trying so hard right now.
Mike Rutherford was right on it to make the call. Eric Lau. Outside to O'Hearn. Drives the lane. Behind the back, over the head, pass to Trenholm. He passes it. Mark it at 17-9. Wiscasset is leading. Corey Carr's open for three off the front of the iron. No good. Rebound underneath. Eric Lau went up, stripped of the ball. Lau made the strip on Falkingham. O'Hearn, the dish to Cowette. Baseline drive. Lays it up. It's no good. Rebound. Call down by Bliley. Packard is all over him, and they call the foul.
Watch this. This is like trying to catch a mosquito in the dark. Bliley knows he's there. He just can't get rid of him. Looks at Packard in the face. Turns around. Hits him again.
So Wiscasset comes down, leading 17-9. Underneath, turnaround shot by Bliley. Could not catch it. Now at the rebound, and down comes Eric Lau. Lau, into the paint. Shot, no good. Rebound. Bliley. Bliley has that look about him now, too. Falkingham, blocked by Cowan out of bounds. There's your time, 7.3 seconds.
T.J. Cowette has influenced many of those inside shots. He's blocked three of them already that I can recall easily.
Whoa. From downtown, Corey Carr at the buzzer. And Wiscasset is on top by 11. at the end of one quarter of play. Our score, the Wisconsin Redskins 20, the Winthrop Ramblers 9. We'll be back right after this.
An island off the west coast of Canada, remote, isolated, unspoiled. For thousands of years, inhabited by a race of black bears who have never seen a human being. But among them, adventurous, solitary, and curious, resides a bear that is almost pure white. This is his story. Ghost Bear, next time on Nature.
Stations of the Maine Public Television System, WCBB, Television Channel 10 in Augusta. Let's go to John Coughlin for an injury update on Steve Contreras.
John, I'm talking with Chris Cementelli, and Steve Contreras' ankle did go over. They've taken the tape off. They're applying ice to it at this point in time. His ankle is elevated. They'll determine at halftime whether he'll be back in the second half. John?
Thank you, John. We can see Contreras on the bench right now with the ice pack on the ankle. He will watch with interest from the bench the rest of this first half. We're in the second quarter. Wisconsin shocking Winthrop 20-9. Their hands are everywhere. Here's O'Hearn down the lane, trying to dish it off to Trenholm. Knocked out of bounds by the Redskins. Still Winthrop Rambler ball. I tell you, Wisconsin has come out here very quick. Cat-like.
They've been that way all year long.
Packer dropped it out of bounds. Pancreedy to put it in, gets it into Torrey Carr, who stuck a three-pointer right at the end of the quarter. Cross court, long pass, and Pancreedy saves it. Goes up to the shot and gets it. Mm-hmm. 22-9. Wisconsin leading Winthrop. Here's O'Hearn at the top of the circle. He outruns his dribble, but it comes for Cowett underneath the Packard and knocked away. Wiley got his mitts on it.
Johnson's open.
Here's Tancredi for two. And Winthrop has really got to talk this one over. Right now, Wisconsin is simply chewing them up.
They're chewing them up in part because Winthrop can't get its offense going. The Wisconsin defense triggering everything that's happening in the offensive end of the court for the Redskins. Wisconsin has denied the entry pass, has made it tough for Winthrop to score points. Winthrop is having trouble getting T.J. Cowett the ball. If they can't get him the ball, he can't start anything. He's got to settle into his game. He's got to start taking over without overtaking.
And Warren Cosette, the head coach of Wisconsin, knows, I think he's well aware, that this is the point in the ballgame that Winthrop likes to go on one of those runs where they score 22 points in a row. And yet, he's going to have to tell his sergeants, don't let up.
They've got to keep doing what they're doing. This may be fine. You know, they played Bonnie Eagle, they played Bangor, they played Falmouth over the Christmas break. But I don't think they've seen a team quite like Wisconsin.
Here's Packard. Into Cowett. Turnaround jump shot is no good. Bliley will get called for the foul. His shirt, David, is soaked.
Well, they're all perspiring heavily here. They're working very, very hard. Obviously, what Dave Poulin said, would you please get the ball into the hands of number 50 in white. 50 in white. Our guy.
They've had a problem with that. Wisconsin's defense superb. T.J. Cowett at the line hits the first of two shots. Four team fouls assessed against Wisconsin. Five against Winthrop. Cowett hits them both. 24-11. Wisconsin is leading. Wiley, the dish, field, return to Tancredi, and he gets knocked down.
I think Jeff Packard was there with a little bit too much force.
This will be the 16th foul on Winthrop, which means they have no more to give. Dan Creedy's shaking his head.
What hit me?
I got hit by a Packard. That's right. 6.5 minutes left to go as Tancredi misses the first end of the two-shot foul. Next foul on Winthrop, and Wisconsin will be in the 1-1. Redskins have two to give. Here's Tancredi's second shot. He cans it. 25-11, your score. Wisconsin leading Winthrop. O'Hearn, Lau from downtown, does not get it. Rebound, Hackert to the Ramblers. Bounces it to Cowett. DJ drops the ball, picks it back up. To Lau for three, got it. They needed that. 25-14, that cuts the lead down to 11. Winthrop in the process here, trying to make it manageable. Corey Johnson in the corner for Wisconsin. Johnson to Robert Beal. Out on top at time for Adam Newcomb. Now Johnson in the corner. Beal. Johnson will try from 20 feet. No good. The rebound. Slapped around on the floor. And O'Hearn steps in to pick it up. Down court pass to Packard. Left side of the lane. Lays it up around the rim. No good.
And he's going to get called.
Packard will get called for the foul. We do believe, and if so,
that'll be his third.
That's right.
4-4 on the reach-in. They'll be shooting 1-1.
I think they should be. Rutherford was going to put it in bounds under the Winthrop basket. But they bring it down.
With Jeff Packard with three fouls, 5.5 minutes to play in the second quarter. Steve Contreras, you just saw him there on the bench, ice on his ankle.
Tancredi cans the first end of the 1-1 opportunity.
Things are a tad ugly right now for the Winthrop Ramblers.
Doesn't get the second one. Wisconsin leads by a dozen points. Here's Cowett in the lane. Loose, lays it up. It's no good. TJ is having a rough half. Beal at the top of the circle. Corey Carr had a notion for 3 points. Gets it back. Will try now and doesn't get it. Eric Lyle steps in to take away the rebound. And back come the Winthrop Ramblers. Knocked out of bounds. That'll be Winthrop ball. In the basketball game, replacing Packard.
Is Adam Packard. Hey, Jeff, make room. Baby brother's coming in.
Adam Packard's the junior. Cowett. From the left side, no good. Rebound up and in by Tom Trenholm.
6.5 for Trenholm. Great effort for him already.
And a 10-point Wisconsin lead at 26-16. Here's Corey Carr. Falkingham got it for three.
They left him open in that 1-3-1 defense.
It's 29-16, 13-point lead. Try to answer. It's Adam Packard having the whistle for the foul.
TJ Cowett reaching over the back.
That's two on Cowett.
Picks up his second.
Warren Cosette along the sideline.
There's Corey Johnson going for it. Hey, Trenholm had a pretty good collision in there, too.
And Rod Buck, the referee, right on the call. 29-16. Corey Johnson to the line to shoot the 1-1. 4:15 left to go in the first half. Corey Johnson. 6'3" junior.
A baby Moses Malone.
This one on the rebound. They called another foul. Falkingham. Now it's as Cassett has one more foul to give before they're in the one-and-one situation. O'Hearn. Adam Packard to O'Hearn, nearly stolen by Carr. Just now to Trenholm, he cans the layup. 29-18. With Cassett is leading here in the first half. We go under 4 minutes. Johnson scores.
13 points for Corey Johnson.
He's on fire. There's Eric Lau out on top. O'Hearn drives. Gets it off to Adam Packard. Johnson missed on the steal. And we get the whistle. Johnson may have committed a foul here.
I believe he did.
Coming back.
Adam Packard thinks so.
Johnson picks up two. Jason Nuzzo had a long time on the bench, and Trenholm some quality minutes for Winthrop.
Tommy's already got 8 points on the night for the Ramblers. Corey Johnson's going to take a seat. This opens up the middle even more for T.J. Cowette.
Andy O'Hearn, the Lau in the corner. Cross court now. Adam Packard looking for Cowette. He wants the ball, but Packard says, I can't get it to you. Here's Packard. To Cowette. Cowette. The pop shot is good. Corey Carr went down on the play. 31-20. With Cassett by 11. And in the center, blocking foul to be called on, I believe.
Justin Sancredi.
Sancredi. And that's it.
But you know,
with Cassett goes to the 1-1.
He got the worst end of that. He hit the deck hard. Nuzzo is going to go to the line for the 1-1. And this could be the ripple. With Johnson on the bench, Winters can get back in this in a hurry.
Two very different coaches in this. Cool and basically reserved, quiet. Warren Cosette animated, screaming and yelling.
Intensity has several manifestations, doesn't it?
I mean, Cosette over there looks like a guy having an anxiety attack. Here's Nuzzo. Missing the front end of the 1-1, and he will not get a chance at the second. Robert Beal, cross court to Carr, drives on Nuzzo. Left side of the lane, puts up the shot, it's no good. Rebound, Faulkingham, yes.
Kid's impressive as a sophomore, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Nuzzo, cross court to Lau. Another talented sophomore. Here's O'Hearn, off to Nuzzo, drives right side, puts it up, it's no good, grabs his own rebound, that is no good. And Tancredi down with the rebound for Wiscasset.
No place for the timid in there, pal.
13 points, you saw the lead for Wiscasset over Winthrop. 2 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the first half. No, it has been rough, David, you're right. Down low.
Matt Harris is back in for Nuzzo. Winthrop needs some offense from somebody.
Here's Trenholm on the drive. Leaves it for Harris. Harris out on top to O'Hearn. T.J. Cowette lines up a three and throws an air ball. Cowette to Lau for three. Nailed it. Cuts the lead to 10, 33-23. A minute and 40 left to go in the first half.
6 points for Eric Lau, 2 3-pointers.
Corey Carr on the right side. Faulkingham returns the pass to him. Faulkingham to Carr. They're playing pass on the right side. Here's Carr trying to take Harris down low. Does so. Kicks it back out to Bliley. In underneath. And 3-3 for 2. 35-23. Wiscasset by a dozen.
9 of those dozen, Justin Tancredi.
Cowette, paint, running hook shot, no good. Rebound, knocked out of bounds, and they're going to call the foul. 35-23. Wiscasset over Winthrop. We're in the second quarter. In the right-hand part of your screen, You can see the time remaining, just about a minute, Dave.
Whoop, there's the whack.
Number 55, Tom Stenholm, from behind, picks up his first personal foul. That's 9 fouls, which means 2 shots. Riley, nothing but the bottom of the net. Six-foot-three-inch senior. And again, 37-23. Wiscasset leads by 14 points. Stenholm, Delisle for three. He got it.
Again, another sophomore guard. Wow.
Down to 40 seconds now. 37-26. Wiscasset's going to go off at halftime with a lead. Tancredi lays it up. It's no good. The rebound, Matt Harris. Half a minute to work with. O'Hearn nearly stolen from behind. Looks inside for Cowett. Loose in the lane. Lays it up around the rim and out. That's the type of half it's been for T.J. Cowett. Down quickly. Wiscasset. Falkingham for three. Yes!
Seven points for Falkingham.
Here's Cowett with the response. He gets it as we run out of time here in the first half.
Wooden paddles and just can't collect them on the basketball. But the way they play, you think, you know, they're up and down the court so quickly, you would figure that they would create not only or cause more turnovers themselves, but it doesn't happen because they all have good hands. This is just a tremendous group of athletes that Warren Cassette has for the Wisconsin Redskins. And 12 points is not a lot to make up for the Winthrop Ramblers. But when you're playing a team as good as Wisconsin, you don't like to dig yourself quite that deep a hole.
We'll have the second half. We saw the replay at home. He went down in a heap, and he was writhing.
I was afraid it was knee-to-knee with Corey Johnson.
That should have been very serious.
But it's the ankle. Here we go.
Here's Torrey Carr. The starter for Wiscasset. Beal, left side. Inside to Johnson. Drives, lays it up from the left. That's his place. That's where he likes to score from, but misses it this time. Here's Andy O'Hearn back for Winthrop. Ramblers with a hill to climb. Hackers. Second inside to Lau. O'Hearn out on top. Packers on the drive. Gets it to the left side of the lane. Nuzzo turnaround, jump shot, no good. Rebound comes down for Wiscasset, and Tancredi has left it in the backcourt for Robert Beal. Corey Carr on the right side. Here's Tancredi in the corner. Goes up over Nuzzo. Does not get it. Back come the Ramblers. Packers. Head fake. Into the lane. Shot, no good. Rebound. Nuzzo puts it up. Yes. Nuzzo cuts the Wiscasset lead to 10 points, 40-30. Robert Beal. Corey Carr had a notion. Now this is off to Bliley. He's open for the 10-footer. That's good. 42-30. A dozen points the lead now for Wiscasset. Jeff Packard. Underneath the Nuzzo, he puts it up, and he's going to be fouled.
Corey Johnson crossed the arm. And I believe what Wiscasset has decided to do, there you see the reaching foul by Johnson. Probably hurt it just as well as the microphone on the backboard. Picks up a slap of skin on skin. Johnson comes out, that's his third foul. This is Winthrop's opportunity right here, Don. But the thing is that Wiscasset right now is going to say, everybody else on Winthrop can beat us. Cowett will not. They are denying him the ball to the degree that they can. And forcing Nuzzo and Jeff Packard and Eric Lau, Andy O'Hearn to make the shot.
Nuzzo can cut it to 10. The lead, that is. Off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound controlled by Cowett. He's up again. Takes the shot off the front of the iron. DJ Cowett has been cold in this basketball game. The lead is 11. 6 minutes left to play, third quarter. And the Redskins on the outside work it now. Stolen by O'Hearn. O'Hearn at the other end tried to lay it up. It'll be deflected out of bounds by Torrey Carr, the Wisconsin Redskins. Jeff Packard, guarded by Carr. Benuzzo, turn around, and Cowette hits one.
First time in a while it's been under 10.
It is 42-33. The Wisconsin lead is down to 9. The Ramblers looking to make a run here. Flyley, other ideas, gets it to Carr. Nice bounce pass to Santrini. And the whistle for a foul, it's on Benuzzo. Let's check it.
Maybe. She goes 5-2. It is. It's on 50. It's T.J. Cowette at the third. He and Johnson now have 3.
Here's Cowette getting himself in foul trouble. Just a little tap on the arm.
Should have been on Benuzzo.
Look at that. Oh, not me.
Jason volunteered.
I thought it was Benuzzo, but you're right. He was volunteering. I'll take it. Tancredi hits the first one. Second one is on the way. No. Corral by Jeff Packard. Packard now to O'Hearn, and O'Hearn will bring it over the timeline to Eric Lau. Here's Cowette in the corner. They've really got the middle plugged up. O'Hearn underneath for Benuzzo, intercepted by Bliley. Back come the Redskins with a 10-point lead. 5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Robert Beal and Torrey Carr on the outside. Adam Newcomb in the corner. Three-pointer by Beal is good. Wisconsin just will not let Winthrop break through. Here's O'Hearn down the lane for two. 46-35. The lead is 11. Torrey Carr for three, off the iron, no good. The rebound comes down to T.J. Cowette, and T.J. likes to take it in these situations, end-to-end, spots up for a three and doesn't get it. Benuzzo, the rebound, up and in. I think Wisconsin will want timeout now. Yes, they do. 4 minutes and 9 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. It is Wisconsin 46. And Winthrop 37. The lead is 9 points.
Now, you deal in rumor mills all the time when you get near a big sporting event such as this. And where there was talk that T.J. Cowette was a little dinged, it wasn't that he hurt his hand, his shoulder, his elbow, got a knock on the head. It was there was a talk that he had a groin injury or hamstring injury, something bothers the leg. More than anything else, Don, and this is underplayed by everybody but Chris Cimentelli, the legs are what control a shooter. And if there's something wrong with T.J. Cowette that would alter a shot, it's more likely to come from the legs than it is. And Larry Bird made a living in the NBA after he mangled his finger in a softball game. But he couldn't play anymore when the legs would go bad, when the back gave out. And Cowette is out here. If there's something, could be soft tissue, but if there's something wrong with him, the legs will affect the shooting more than the arm will.
Here's O'Hearn the steal. Cowette dishes in the paint to Benuzzo. He lays it up. It's no good. Rebound battle for inside. Benuzzo and Packard had Bliley pinned, but he got away. Carr. The deal. Carr drives. Dishes it off to Tancredi. The 8-footer is no good. Tancredi is on rebound. Up and in. Cowette tried to answer with a three. T.J. has been told to get the whistle inside. The score now runs to 48-37 in favor of Wisconsin. 3 minutes and 34 seconds left to play here in the third quarter.
Steve Contreras and Adam Packard check in. Contreras will know in the first 5 steps
We'll watch him close. He's number 25. Inbounds it comes. He seems ready. He immediately is involved in a collision. They call him for the foul.
Well, he thought he had position before Newcomb got there.
Sorry, a 13 foul. Contreras injured in the first half by the ankle, favoring it just a bit. As Wiscasset comes down. Newcomb to Beal for three. Yes.
7 points for Beal.
The three-pointers have been lit up here, and it's hurting Winthrop badly. Inside to Cowett, turnaround jump shot. That will not go.
Over the back.
On the rebound again. Wiley will get the call. This is only the second team foul in the half assessed against Wiscasset.
If Wiscasset has played better, notwithstanding the fact that Jeremy Rankin, one of their starters, is on the bench and not even in uniform, I can't imagine how. They are just playing an outstanding basketball game.
Contreras inbounds, and for three, wild side, no good, a rebound Contreras, and that does not go. Here comes Beal on the run. He's got it. Robert Beal has scored the last 5 points. And Wiscasset is running away from Winthrop. 2 minutes and 48 seconds left to go in the third quarter. It is Wiscasset 53 and Winthrop 37.
The Winthrop fans sit in almost stunned silence. Their team has not put the ball in the basket.
A little early, but I think they're getting a whiff of what might happen.
Well, you go 16 points up against a Winthrop team that's undefeated coming in here. You can walk the walk right now.
And you know what happens. As each minute goes by, Wiscasset gets more and more confident.
Well,
they start to believe, yes, we can.
They run a fast break, and it's unselfish basketball. Beal has been big in the third quarter.
Adam Packard, and before he got to make his cut, we get a push. This may be on Bliley. Let's check it. It is number three. But Bliley's in a bit of trouble. Inbound to Packard, now to Cowett. Turnaround spin move is off the rim, no good. Grabs his own rebound on the other side, puts it up and in.
He can do that better than anybody this side of Corey Johnson.
53-39, Wiscasset is leading. Bliley for three, no. And O'Hearn the rebound. Brought on your screen if you just tuned in. It is a surprise. There's Packard with nothing. Cowett back up and in. 53-41. The lead is down to a dozen. 2 minutes left to go. Third quarter. Newcomb will back out. Now it's worked underneath the car. Carr, guarded by O'Hearn, will take him into the paint and score it. 55-41.
They're doing this with Corey Johnson on the bench, too.
Slapped away from Cowett. And back comes Wiscasset. Very good defense. Very quick hands for the Redskins tonight.
And they collapse on Cowett. Looks like a Venus flytrap.
Corey Carr will drive. He's got a lane. Dishes it off underneath. Nice play. Dan Freedy. And a good block by Eric Lau. Back comes Cowett, end-to-end, lays it up and in. To 43.
18 points on the night for Cowett. Considerably off his average still.
The lead still belongs to Wiscasset by a dozen. Sampreedy looping it in to Carr. Corey drives the lane and...
Adam Packard on the reach, I believe.
That's right. Adam Packard got a hand on him. There's your score, 55-43. With Cassett has kept it right there around 10, 12 points, the lead, all game long. It's seesawed a bit in the early going of the first quarter, but then it's been all with Cassett.
Coet is doing his best to take over the game. They see 32 in red. Corey Johnson, he's just waiting.
They got them both. Sampreedy did. 57-43. Here's O'Hearn. 10-footer. It's good. Knocked out of bounds as Winthrop applies some pressure. But now 47 seconds left to go in the third quarter.
Torrey Carr just dribbled it off his leg.
But Cassett with the 12-point lead. Knocked out of bounds. We'll just do it all over again. O'Hearn. Eric Lau will pop it from the right side and does not draw iron.
Partially blocked.
Redskins come down with a half a minute to work with. Here's Torrey Carr. Underneath Newcomb and laid up by Briley. Not a design play by any stretch of the imagination, but Briley in the right place at the right time. Cowett had a notion. Three-point land punched away from him. Picked up by Carr. 5 seconds left and Carr will be fouled.
5-0 and White is some frustrated right now. He goes to make a move. He runs into a team picture, but with Cassett defense. He's got three guys, and there's no place for him to go. He can't squeeze through that opening.
Everybody was there. Inbound. Carr lays it up. No good. A rebound comes down to Cowett, and he is fouled. The buzzer goes off, but Cowett will go to the line.
No, he won't.
No. Oh, no, it's not the one and one yet.
Definitely not going to cost.
Only three fouls. At the end of three quarters of play, here's your score. Class C boys, Western final. It is Winthrop trailing. Wisconsin leads 59-45.
If they get something cranked on offense.
Here's Cowett trying to make it happen. He drives into the lane, but does not get the shot. He will get fouled.
If Beal holds up his arms, hey, who, me? Gee, I didn't think so.
Well, they never do. Corey Johnson has returned. Now that misses the first shot. And gets the second one. 59-46 with Cassett the lead, trapping defense now by Winthrop, forces Torrey Carr to call a timeout.
I'm looking down here. Adam Packard has no points tonight. Brother Jeff Packard, no points tonight. They may be relying on number 50, but somebody else has to come through. So far, Trentle made 8 points in the first half. He hasn't had any here in the second. Jason Newsoff had a couple, but the offensive load has been borne principally by T.J. Cowett. And it's very tough, you know, considering how Winthrop likes to play and how good they've been in the interior passing. They have not had that many opportunities with Cassett has played so well.
They have. There's your score, 59-46. With Cassett is leading Winthrop with 7 minutes and 43 seconds left to go here in the boys' Class C Western Final. Winner here goes on to the state championship next week on Friday night, I believe. Yes, on Friday night. The loser hands in the shirts.
Corey Johnson.
All alone. Easiest 2 points he's gotten all season. 61-46. Here's Lau for three. He nails it. 61-49. Again, the lead hangs at 12 points. Bet underneath the Tancredi. He got Cowett to come in the air and then laid it in. They are beating the press. Johnson steals. Gets it back. Corey Carr. Nate Falkingham. Underneath, Tancredi the lay.
Winthrop has to take chances, and they're getting burned. Wiscasset's anticipating so well, they have all the answers right now.
Wiscasset just is too good a team. So when you take chances, you're right. You do get burned. Here's Jeff Packard. Andy O'Hearn kicks it out to Packard, the three-pointer. No good. The rebound down to Nate Falkingham. Carr. Johnson. Puts it up, and they'll call him for player control.
That's his fourth foul.
So Johnson is in foul trouble.
Unofficially, I've got Tancredi for 17.
There it is. Next, Wiscasset foul puts Winthrop in the 1-1. Packard. Looks inside for Trenholm, finds him left side of the lane, he lays it up and in.
Nice basket, Tom Trenholm.
Nice entry pass. Jeff Packard. 65-51, here's the response from Robert Beal.
The team quickness for the Wiscasset Redskins.
67-51. Three-point bomb is corralled by Cowett. He puts it up and in, counts the basket. He'll go to the line to shoot.
Again, unofficially, 21 points for Cowett.
Here's Beal committing his second personal foul. They're going to give it to Beal. It looked like Carr had most of Cowett. Looks like Robert was standing around watching.
They've had Beal singled out last two fouls.
Cowett collects everything he can squeeze out of a three-point play. 67-54, a 13-point lead. We are under 6 minutes now. Nate Falkingham. Corey Carr. Johnson loose again. Lays it in. And down court. As Lau makes the move, it goes over to Wiscasset. And now you're looking into the Wiscasset stands where they've been whooping it up in back of us all night long, David. They are happy right now with that, a 15-point lead at 69-54. Corey Carr, got a three, gonna try and stick it, and doesn't. Rebound, battle for it, Tancredi. Dances along the sideline and comes away with it. Underneath, laid up and in by Falkingham.
Well, I'll tell you, they play well. Finding the open man.
71-54. Wiscasset is leading Winthrop. 4 minutes and 44 seconds left to go in the game. There's Steve Contreras. Wow, we'll drive the lane. Dishes it out to Packard for three.
Got it.
Wiscasset. Lost by Tancredi. Ahead to Contreras. Running at the other end. He lays it up no good. Long down court pass. Tancredi. Behind his back. But Contreras had pushed him.
This is one that you can, I believe, credit Steve Contreras' bum ankle. He didn't have the mobility. He couldn't cut on a dime.
That's the last foul that Winthrop has to get. There you see it.
Nice camera work, people. Good shot. Thank you.
Corey Carr out on top. Robert Beals. Trying to get to Bangor and the state championship. The Wisconsin Redskins. Set underneath. Nice one to Beal, and Beal hurt his elbow. When he went down, he is in pain. You could hear it from up here. You heard the bone strike the floor.
The floor one. That hurt.
Now watch when he spins. Contreras with the foul. And he lands right on his right elbow. But he's all right. Here's Eric Lau. The 10-foot pop from the free throw line is good. 71-59. Winthrop taking chances on defense now. And stolen by Cowette. Cowette, end to end, will lay it up and no good. It has not been TJ's night. Corey Carr with the basketball. Under 3.5 minutes to go. Your score, Wisconsin 71, Winthrop 59.
No hurry for the Redskins.
Nope, they're going to spread the floor now. Got it overloaded to one side. Here's Falkingham. Watch Packard go by, and it's Johnson, and Johnson spins, and he's going to be fouled.
Contreras on the reach in. I believe that'll be team foul number 7, which will put Corey Johnson to the line unofficially.
It is the one-on-one. Beal comes out for a breather.
Unofficially 17 for Corey Johnson.
Four fouls on Contreras now.
What a great tournament for Wisconsin.
Yes. And struggled against number 7 Booth Bay early in the game. Since that time, they have simply regrouped, gotten it all together. And you can hear them talking to each other. A lot of communication. Warren Cosette, 3 minutes away from a shot at the golden ball. Contreras is down. Is that Contreras? No,
no, it's
Eric
Lau.
It is Lau who hit the floor. It has been rough, but not exceedingly so.
Well, these kids they're pushing it as hard as they can go.
Because there is no tomorrow.
Well, there'll be a tomorrow. Just one team's going to have a practice.
Gonna be,
the other one
team's going to be involved in it. When we go back on the court for action, there will be 3 minutes even left to play.
And somebody asked me the other day, Don, not that I had an intelligent answer, but somebody asked me the other day whether the design of the footgear for these kids had reached the point where it was better than the conditions could warrant, because it now placed the pressure on your joints.
Uh-huh.
So you can actually stop too fast, and you can pop a knee, the way Jeremy Rankin may have.
Yes. He did not start tonight.
You know, similar to what happens when you talk about, the football injuries with the artificial surface. So you're placing too much torque and what have you on joints that are not designed to handle that.
Contreras to Adam Packard for three, does not get it. And the ball down to Tancredi, and Tancredi back with it. On the hands of Corey Carr, over the timeline, and Carr fouled immediately, and Winthrop is in a position now where they have to foul just to get the ball back.
They don't have enough time left on.
73-59, Wisconsin. Game seesawed in the first quarter, but then Wisconsin with some very good defense. Picked up some key steals, some key baskets, and some three-pointers. And put about a 10 to 12 point distance between them and Winthrop for just about the entire game. Here's Corey Carr hitting two. It is 75-59.
Wiley, Carr, Beal, Johnson, Tancredi, and Falkingham.
Cowette. With the shot, no good. Rebound Johnson. Here's is Falkingham, Tancredi in the corner, back out on top it comes. The Torrey car. Wiley's going to hang on with it. No rush here. Cowette steals the basketball. Cowette underneath the Nuzzo. He lays it up and no good. Winthrop is ice cold. Lau will go to the line. Corey Johnson just fouled out. He fouls out with 2 minutes and 8 seconds to go.
Hey, I don't want to see him hang his head. He did his damage out here for Wisconsin. Of course they're going to go after him. What did he expect?
Corey Johnson has played a wonderful game. Maybe the game of his life.
Jeremy Rankin consoling him there, telling him to keep your chin up. Come on, let's go. Look at the scoreboard. Don't worry about it. We're playing on Saturday.
Meanwhile, Friday. Johnson ends with 19 points. Lau hits the pair, 75 to 61. 14-point lead now for Wisconsin. There are 2 minutes left to go in the basketball game. Winthrop has to foul underneath of Bliley. Bliley got whacked by Cowette. The Wisconsin bench wants an intentional foul. Bliley looks him right in the eye.
He can look all he wants. That was a pretty good foul. He wasn't going to let him have the layup. Watch the reach here.
Here's Bliley.
Bliley takes the step for a power layup. I think what he objected to was the body hitting him in the head. Not so much the arm slap on the ball.
Bliley misses the first one.
But Eric has a flair for the dramatic.
And misses the second one. Here's Tancredi, the putback.
Oh,
up and down. Left his feet once, came down, went back up again. Clever if you can get away with it, but you seldom do. The officiating outstanding in this tournament. As usual, Rod Buck and Mike Rutherford have done a great job. Here's Nuzzo trying to get something to happen for Winthrop, but it will not fall. We are 90 seconds from the finish.
As the two sophomores meet at the point. Eric Lau and Nate Falkingham. Falkingham will go to the line. Boy, these kids, they got a couple more years to play. It's going to be fun.
Look at Tancredi. He's got a smile on his face. He takes it off now. But he was just grinning from ear to ear. He can feel it.
He's perhaps more aware of the clock. These guys are in the game. And there may be some personal statements being made out there. You know, nothing terribly rambunctious.
77 to 61. 16 points the lead for Wisconsin. And the time ticking down. Here's Packard underneath the Nuzzo. Nuzzo's walking. You have to wonder how he got to the other side of the lane. Well, he just walked there. Winthrop will apply full court pressure all the time now. An attempt to steal the ball. Now, here's Bliley. They beat the pressure. Falkingham to Bliley inside. He puts it up. It's no good. Foul from behind.
I believe Packard will be called. But again, that's an academic distinction because Wisconsin has played so well. They can beat the press that Winthrop throws at them. They really have got a tremendous amount of quickness.
Corey Johnson fouled out. With 2:08 left, but he had already
wreaked
havoc.
Salute the players who know
they know it.
There will be no tomorrow.
They know it's lost, but the Winthrop fans are on their feet for a standing ovation. And what a game Wisconsin came to play.
Now, in its own way, this one hurt. But it doesn't hurt as much as if they got that close. You know, that hairbreadth away and had it ripped from them. Because Wisconsin has thoroughly and soundly defeated a very strong Winthrop Rambler basketball team.
There has been no doubt about it. It is 79 to 61. as Quiley hit both ends of the two-shot foul. Now it's stolen. Thrown down court. And I'll tell you something. Casey Patton is not going to catch up with it. 61 seconds left. And the time rolling down in the corner of the screen. O'Hearn, Matt Harris, out of bounds by Beal. And he's got a little grin on his face.
You look over at the Wisconsin bench, they can't put anybody else in. These boys are in.
Intercepted by O'Hearn, he's still in. O'Hearn off the treadmill. He'll lay it up and in and get fouled. Treadhome will go to the line. The score now stands 79-63 in favor of Wisconsin. There's Tommy Treadhome with the shot. He got it. 79-64. Newcomb underneath to Bliley. Bliley going to dish it off, and we get the whistle. Dropped out of bounds. It'll belong to the Winthrop Ramblers. O'Hearn, 1/2 a minute left to go, and Wisconsin is going to the state final. Matt Harris from the side rattles it around and in. We go down under 10 seconds. Very, very shortly.
What an impressive victory for Wisconsin.
Well, it begins as a dream in basketball camp all the way back to last summer. Everybody with the same dream. And for Wisconsin, the dream comes true.
Score 81 points against the Winthrop Ramblers, I should bet.
No need to say anything. The pictures will tell the story.
The growing rights belong to the Wisconsin Redskins. Surprising, Don, that Wisconsin won the game. I think the margin of victory is the thing that is kind of surprising.
It is. Somebody just leaned over. Well, thank you. Maine Public Television was happy to provide you with good pictures. Some of the fans here have just been wonderful. Still from New York. Well.
Oh. I don't know what.
81-66. Bliley's got his piece of the net. At the other end, Corey Carr will go for his piece of the net.
It was not the baskets made tonight by Winthrop, it was the baskets missed.
By the way,
if they had a decent shooting percentage, it would have been a lot closer.
I just wanted to point out that the guy who puts the nets up is Kurt Cooper.
Thank you very much. Don't suppose they ain't related to Bruce Cooper, do you?
No.
Not a chance.
Corey Carr. On the road to Bangor. As you look into a sea of red, the Wisconsin fans. And we'd just like to say one thing. We agree with the lady. To our crew, wonderful pictures.
The Winthrop fans, this is unaccustomed for them. They don't lose very often.
Well, they didn't lose at all this year, except for tonight.
Well, they lost in the Christmas tournament, a game that did not count in the schoolboy standings.
Thank you.
to introduce the interim coach of the Rambles and his assistant coach, Tom Tucker and Mike Gindra, to present their awards. I'd like to introduce head coach Ron Cassette and his assistant coaches, Bill Carr, Mike Levitt, and Rennie Bishop. If they would come up to present the awards, please. This time, the coaches will present the awards to the managers, Darren Bagley. John Dreamer.
Hey, John.
Jessica James. Alicia Bond. And Jessica Moody. And now the team personnel, sophomores Adam Newcomb. Nate Falkingham. Casey Patton. Jesse Cheney.
Hey, Jeff.
Junior Rob Beal. Corey Johnson. Is that Corey Kass?
Yeah, Corey.
Corey Kass. Senior Corey Kass. Senior Eric Gallard. Senior Justin Tancredi. And senior Jeremy Rankin. This time, if we could have the Wisconsin captains and the head coach to accept the plaque on behalf of the Maine Principals Association. I'd like to present you this plaque, emblematic of the boys' captain's plaque.